Hello again, everyone. Welcome back to Final Fantasy III. Now, let's just leave the Invincible there for anyone to steal while we head into Fargabad and head into their cave. So, there are lots of secret passages here. Let's go get another Thor Hammer. Why we're getting a Thor Hammer now, I don't know. Anyway, the secret passages all connect, and they're not too difficult to figure out where you're going. Oh, wow. Cyranos? Is that a carrion crawler? Well, it's called a garb. These are interesting-looking enemies. Eh, let's just bolt three them. There's only one level to this cave, so it's all a side quest, so you don't even have to come. Oh my god! I love you guys. I love you guys so much. I believe all of these enemies can split when hit with regular attacks, and they're weak to those weapons, so that's the thing. Eh, let's just go with fire two, whatever. And an arrow. So yeah, I think that's why we're doing so much damage. These enemies are weak to these weapons. Wow, we're getting quite a bit of capacity. Alright, we actually want to bypass all of those and go this way, bypass that one. And actually, I have messed up. We don't actually want to go this way. I think you guys are staying as Mystic Knights for a while. Man, with those kinds of attacks. Almost wonder if I should have made someone else one into a Mystic Knight. I mean, Ellie's damage is not holding up with at this point, to be honest. Of course, part of the problem is that if I switch into anything else, then I'm not going to get the magic multiplier that Ellie currently has. Hello. You know what? I don't care. You're not gonna actually be doing anything. Let's have some fun. Confusion. Oh yeah, the getting hit sprite for these guys is pretty funny. Their helmet gets larger. Or the opening in their helmet. So much damage. Hey, I confused it. That might not be a good thing, now that I think about it. Eh, let's bio it. We get a Kotetsu and an Ashura. .248 compared to .148. You know, maybe I should even that damage up a little bit. 188. 208. Interesting. Let me actually take a look at, the weapon stats. Ashura is 65, Kiku is 125, okay, Kotetsu is only 105. Okay, so Kiku and... Oops. Ashura and... Kotetsu. There we go. Evens out a little bit better. Oh, hi, Deathclaws. Guess what? I can finally get my revenge on you guys. Ooh, I think I need to do some healing. Alright. Goofed up a little bit there. That is a case where I would have killed them both in one round, but I did not. There we go. Now you can die. So the Deathclaws apparently are not actually weak to the Dark Swords. 160 experience points. That's just crap. All right. Now we want to go this way. This way. And over here. And we get another set of demon armor. I mean, I suppose I could make Ellie into another Mystic Knight. That might not be a bad thing. There we go. That's more like it. I don't know why these enemies don't split with these weapons. I don't know what it would be about these weapons that would do that. It's nothing like they're saying that they're silver or something like that. I'm gonna go with another bio, whatever. Oh, we're gonna be heading out anyway. Experience points. I mean, they're great for money, but just utter crap for experience points. I don't think there's anything this way that you can do. That I will say about Final Fantasy III is that it definitely has some very strange monster designs. Then again, there were some very strange monster designs in Final Fantasy II. I think it's just that I remember many of the Final Fantasy II monster designs showing up in VI. Some of these might show up in 5 now that I think about it. Hi, Deathclaw. Guess what? Have a bio. Have an arrow too, whatever. You know, I think I will make Ellie into another Mystic Knight. I won't have magic for her, but that's fine. Incidentally, the magic that they can use, Cure, Pure, and Sight on level 1, Toad and Mini on level 2. They cannot use Arrow, which is the same as the Hunter, which is kind of annoying. Cure 2, Exit, and Wash for level 3. So, I just got everything because, whatever, I mean, I got a fat Chocobo, why not? Alright, so, item-wise, I have... 2 Asheras and Demon Mail. So yes, I can make Ellie into a Mystic Knight. Go ahead and do that. Out of my way. Move it. You suck. I hate you. I hate you, buddy. There we go. All right. Actually, it's fairly cheap to switch. Actually, the Black Wizard, fairly cheap to switch into anything. So one of the nice things about this game is that when you change classes, your stats are actually fixed. So everyone is level 35, so 39, 39, 24, 19, 20. So, it doesn't matter what class you are, stat-wise. Obviously, equipment can make some difference. Actually, whoa. It's pretty expensive to go from Mystic Knight into anything else. Geomancer is the cheapest. Actually, it looks like Thief might have been fairly cheap, too. Did I fully equip? Wrong person. I did, yes. Go. All right, so this will serve us fairly well in the next area, I think. I hope. Wouldn't be the first time that I've screwed up my class assignments. Actually, I could probably go someplace else, but I might want Ellie as a Black Wizard for that. Maybe I should have done that, actually. You know? Let me see what items there are. Actually, yes. Yes. All right. Let me put Ellie back as a Black Wizard. We will we'll do something else first. It's an optional thing, so it's nice and free to change into the Black Wizard. All right. Here, swallow these swords. Thank you. And I definitely want light. I'll take the flame and the ice, I guess. Grab the scholar. Black robe. Protect ring. And that should be good. Alright, we want light. And I'll take flame, I guess. There we go. Alright, so the reason is because we are going to have some side questing time. I suppose it might have been better to leave Ald and Crow in their other classes, but that shouldn't be a problem. I hope. Take off! Alright, now, we actually need to get to the floating continent, so it's gonna take a little while with this ship. We have to take this ship. Couldn't have done it before you got the Invincible. I went out into the sea a little bit too far. And unfortunately, the Invincible is a little bit slow. I do like how it's got two masts to the side, and you can see the two masts when we go inside the ship. Am I gonna miss it? I shouldn't miss it. I have missed it. There it is. I like how the Invincible is about the same size as the floating continent. That's pretty awesome. Alright, so we actually have two side quests to do. Yes. Look at that. We can jump over here. What cave is this again? I forget what cave this is. Oh yeah, the Gurgan Valley. That's right. Okay. Wait, I could get out that way, but I can't get back in? Oh, that's just cheap. Okay. There we go. Hello? Lake Doll. Did we just sink to the bottom or something? What? I think we were supposed to have been swallowed here or something like that, but I'm not sure. Anyway. I don't actually remember what we face here. Ouroboroses. You guys are pretty easy. Now let's just do confusion. So yeah, damage is probably not going to be as good, but it's still decent. I mean, these are good classes. I think strength is higher with knights and karatekas. We'll go grab these treasures first. A north wind, a phoenix down, an earth drum, and a god's rage. So there's going to be quite a few of those types of items here. Not a whole lot in the way of... like item treasure, equipment treasures. But it's fine. Perfectly happy to kill the Ouroboroses. Ah, good time. A good amount of experience points, too. Lots of high potions and an elixir. So, I mean, they're pretty good items, mind you. Planktay! More of these crab thingies, which are really creepy. And what the hell is that on beneath that coming out of their bottoms? I do not know. I'm gonna keep going with confusion because there's not much else on the on that level of spells to cast. That's glare. How rude! Here, get confused. Have an arrow. Dang it! Now I'll. It's fine. Got skill up with Alden Crow. Always a good thing. Always a good thing. Alright, I want to head up this way because of treasures. A white scent. I don't really remember what many of these items do. I will probably just sell them. Again, the main reason that items in this game aren't very good is that they always have a magic attack multiplier of 1, which just kind of sucks. Thanks, jerk. Here, how about you die? Ineffective. Oh well. He probably died of this bolt, too. Yep. You can go die in a lightning fire. Aegis Shield, Lamia Scale, God's Wine, Turtle Shell. Oh, come on, I was just about to leave the level. Suck. Terrible. Have a bolt. And for good measure, have an arrow too. Because I don't like you guys. You suck. God damn it, why do you always put her to sleep? Stop that! It's rude! That's what you get. I'm building my capacity back up pretty quickly, at least. I mean, you'd really have to be changing classes a lot to use up your capacity. Oh, hey, here are the sea lions. Still, calling them kelpies was a little bit weird earlier in the game. I'm going to arrow to them as well. So we'll get some more treasures up to the north. So yeah, the enemies here are not that difficult. Hey, alright, levels for everyone. I like levels. A black hole, a Thor hammer, reflect armor. Getting a lot of reflect armor. And a dark scent. You better not glare at us. Ow! Alright, maybe I take back what I say about them not being all that difficult. Well, Crow already attacked, so it's okay. Wow, even an arrow killed them. Yeah, it is a fairly high-level spell. Alright, let's do a little bit of healing. There we go. You guys really have to attack me? Can't you see from the mounds of dead sea lion corpses that you're just gonna die? You're not gonna have a chance? You don't have a chance? Come on. Look, see... Oh, okay, alright. Maybe the reason that they're still attacking me is they're not seeing mounds of dead sea lion corpses. Because they disintegrate when they die. That's what happens, right? Alright, we want to go down here for some more treasures. God damn it, stupid sea lions. I don't like you. Get out of here. Oh, well, shoot. Clearly I should have bolt-tued all of them. Apparently, Ellie is the only one who is any good around here. Let's see how those go. Wow, 7 hits. That's pretty impressive. How does a sea lion have 7 hits? Imp's Yawn and a Lilith Kiss. I honestly have no idea what most of those items do. Like, I think the white scent does, holy or something like that. But I'm not actually positive. Good. Got some criticals. Like it. Alright, B4F. What is that? Is that the thing swimming in the lake? I think it may be. Oh, come on. Remora? That's not a Remora. Oh my god. Ow! Jeez. That is rude. Go with an arrow. Arrow 2. Kind of a shame that there isn't an arrow 3. Oh, no, technically there kind of is. Now that I think about it. Alright, let's heal up. How many Bacchus wines do I have? Or God's wines? Only 3. I was thinking about using some, but I don't think I will. Hello?
I am Leviathan. I shall only lend my power to those with the light. Are you worthy?
Maybe? Hi, how's it going? Bolt 3! I'm not sure if wall would do any good. Let's use haste. I don't know that protect would do much good either. Now, actually, now that I think about it, wall would be bad. Was that ineffective, or did that speed up? I don't know. Wow, only 720. Tsunami! It's a pretty cool-looking effect, but oh my god, that damage. No, don't fight. Cure 4. 8 hits, excellent. Oh wow, a miss. He actually attacked rather than did a tsunami, and I got a critical hit. That did not heal as much as I wanted. I mean, it'll keep us going for a little while. But... then again, if he keeps trying to attack too, that's not so bad. Because this should get us about back up to max, yep. Wow. I actually expected that to take, like, 2 more rounds. 5,700 gil, 2 capacity, only 1,250 experience points.
I shall give my power to aid you who have the light.
Obtain Levia! Yep, there is the level 7 summon spell. And just to get it out of our inventory, because, yeah, we're a little bit full. There you go. Now, let's exit. And let's rest. Actually, let's sell some stuff first. Alright, I don't care about the white scent. I don't care about the Imp's Yawn. I don't care about the dark scent. Don't care about the Lilith Kiss. Don't care about the Black Hole. Don't care about the Turtle Shell. Don't care about the Lamia Scale. Don't care about the Earth Drum. Or the God's Rage. Or the North Wind. I don't care about... I'll keep the Aegis Shield. That is worth a lot of money, though. Actually, that's probably what I should have used in the passage underneath Salonia, is Aegis Shields, because that should protect against petrification. There, I have some stuff for you. Take the Reflect Armor, the Thor Hammer, the Aegis Shield. I'll keep the ice on me. Okay, so we've got Leviathan now. Ah, slept well. HBMP restored. In the next episode, we have another little side quest to do before we head back to the main continent and head to the Cave of Darkness. See you next time, everyone.